that's a sign that there's life. So in a way, given that on a cellular level, electromagnetic fields are part of life itself, we could say that all life is electromagnetically sensitive.
Desperate to convince people that electrosensitivity was genuine, Brian and a number of other sufferers signed up to a landmark experiment at Essex University. The experiment, run by Elaine Fox, would sadly become the definitive work on the subject.
You have to go into a shielded room, and you go in there for a relatively short period of time, and the mast is on for 10 minutes and off for 10 minutes and on for 10 minutes, and to see whether you can detect whether it's on or not. And I went into the room, having told them that I would not be able to tell them whether the mast was on or off or on.
Why's that?
Because their understanding of how you react to this is wrong. This is not a case with most people where you turn the mast on and, oh, I'm affected. They turn the mast off, oh, I'm okay again. It doesn't work like that. I suffer with hay fever. And when I go into a field where there's pollen, it takes a while before I'll be affected. But it takes a long time before I'm not affected. I can be removed from the hay field for 24 hours, but I'll still be feeling my hay fever. And electrical sensitivity with most people is a little bit like that.
The way the team had set up the experiment meant it would be almost impossible for Brian and the other volunteers to prove they were being affected. Not that it would matter, as the team had inexplicably decided to do away with any form of vetting procedure.
For one thing, people appear to be sensitive to different things. I'm sensitive to 3G mobile phones, I'm sensitive